pressure supplied to it, and neither is the knee stability, so that you cannot, even if you put them in a plaster, they will not heal. So what happens is you take your graft from the patient's tendons. So those tendons are usually the hamstrings, which are lying just very close to the knee, just here in the tibia. So you take a graft of that tibia by giving a small incision here, and then you pass the graft by making bone tunnels into the femur and bone tunnel into the tibia. So it's like passing the graft from one end, going inside the knee and coming out here. So since it's a graft, it is going through and through the knee, you have to hold it at two places, unless otherwise it will not be stable. So here you you put a button kind of a thing. So the graft goes like that, goes around the button, then comes down, goes inside the bone, and then it comes out in the tibia. Here again you have to paste it and hold it somewhere. So you put in a screw here, okay, just to hold the graft here, yeah, under tension. So this graft has to be under tension only, then it will be able to stabilize the knee. So the graft will be under tension, and this kind of a screw is known as a bio screw. So this screw is usually imported. So this is what it is. It can be a methyl. It can be a bio screw. These are usually two hydroxyapatite screws, which dissolve, which convert into the bone in coming 5 to 7 years, 10 years time. So the patient is very happy that this will ultimately, there will be no metal inside my knee, and this screw will ultimately become bone. So these are usually imported screws, and also this kind of a button which is there. It has a very strong fiber which holds this ligament under tension, which holds this reconstructed ligament under, again this is important. So the quality of the thread here and the quality of the screw here is important. Okay, so these are the two implants. If you get an X-ray, you can you may not be able to make out the screw very clearly, because these are not these are radiolucent screws. Okay, but you can make out the button. But again, Indian button or an imported button will be the same. So you will have to have that barcoding or the packing which you have to give to the patient, so that he can be confident. Okay, I have been given an imported implant. So this is what the ligament surgery would be. Meniscus surgery, again you will have to use implants which you can do through small incisions around the knee, and you can place in some sutures here. Again, there could be small buttons here which can hold onto the threads which go inside the knee, and you can tighten up the torn meniscus here. So in young patients, if it is a fresh injury, you have to try to repair these meniscus. Again, the cost here then increases, because this in the Indian markets comes around 30K. One single button, and this costs somewhere around 40K in the Indian market without markup for the Indian patient. So somewhere this is what the broadly the cost is spread around. So if you use a single implant here, it's around 30K. If we need two, then again 30K, the cost might increase. So we can give you an estimate that he might need a repair, but only peroperatively we'll be able to decide he needs a one button here or two buttons here. This is fixed. This will be fixed. But sometimes if you are able to do a meniscal repair, the number of threads or the number of anchors which we use here, that might Okay, so that's more or less about the arthroscopic surgery of the knee.